What is happening, gamers? This is Bradley here, and welcome back to another news roundup. And to kick us off, Nintendo has announced that they're teaming up with GameStop at select stores around the US to allow people to try a demo of Mario Kart 8 on May 17th and May 18th. The demos won't be playable all day, though. They'll only be available from 12 p.m. to 4 p.m. But it's a nice way to get fans hyped for the game and try the game out, while also getting people who just walk in the store interested in the game. But if you want to check if there's a GameStop location near you that will be participating, there will be a link in the description below so you can check that out. There is one near me, but I'm probably not going to go to it. I just don't feel like going. I'd rather just wait until I get the full product. And from there, that Nintendo shared the first bit of footage for Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, and it really is anything special. I thought maybe they would show some actual gameplay footage of like the trainer running around town or something, but no, they just showed like some cutscenes of the two legendary Pokemon in their 3D form, and that's basically it. I guess it does give us confirmation that the games will have a similar art style to Pokemon X and Y, but I guess that's kind of already expected, so there's that. But it shouldn't be too long now until we hear some fresh new details on Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, as the latest issue of Korokoro is promising new information on the games in their June issue, which will be available on June 14th. But E3 2014 is airing before then, and we'll probably get some new information there, and Korokoro might just reiterate the same stuff. And also related to the Pokemon is that it was recently announced that Pokemon Art Academy would be coming to the 3DS in Japan, but it's already been announced to be getting localized in North America and Europe. This latest entry in the Art Academy series will feature 40 unique lessons that will teach you how to paint, draw, and sketch your favorite Pokemon, which include Pikachu, Oshawott, Charizard, and more. And you'll also be able to share your masterpieces with the world, since there is that little old thing called Miiverse. But this 3DS title is slated to release in the fall of 2014 in North America, so they're still a little ways away, but as for Europe, we have a concrete release date of July 4, so they don't have to wait as long. But back to the topic of E3 2014 though, is that Iwata has confirmed that for those games that they're working on that can only be made possible by the Wii U gamepad and that they're planning to show off at the event, they're being worked on by internal teams at Nintendo under the guidance of Mr. Miyamoto himself. But even better is that these games range from near complete to early in development, which means that we'll probably be getting at least one of these games this year. It was announced in the past that Miyamoto is working on a brand new IP, and one of these games could very well be that, so we'll just have to wait and see what gets announced at E3 2014. And on the indie scene is that Yakko Games has confirmed that they have put together the finished version of Shovel Knight, and they have sent it off to Nintendo for approval. Which means if Nintendo doesn't find any major bugs or anything like that, the game should be coming out in the not too distant future, like in the next few weeks. As for Fuzzy Wuzzy Games Armillo, the game is being slightly delayed, as the submission process is taking longer than they originally anticipated. But as a way to say we're sorry, they will be launching the game at a special discounted price of $5.99 for the first 3 weeks of release. And finally, Two Tribes has confirmed that Swords and Soldiers HD will be releasing on the Wii U in North America and Europe on May 22nd, for the low price of $3 or 3 euros. But that will bring us to the end of the news roundup. If you like what you saw, please give it a thumbs up and add your favorites and all that good stuff, and you can stay tuned for more news videos, video reviews, and That's on Miiverse episodes. I will be doing a video review for Scram Kitty and his buddy on Rails, so you can stay tuned for that, and also the 22nd episode of That's on Miiverse will be going up this Saturday. But I will talk to you later in the next video, guys. Bye! 40 unique lessons that will teach you how to paint, draw, and sketch your favorite Pokemon. Cripes! And on the indie scene is that Yacht Club Games has- Oh, my nose! That itches! Woo! Yeah, that it- Oh, that's better.